Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you how to create your own templates in Pages. So when you go to open a new document in Pages, you'll see that you can create one that's blank or you can use a template. Now, these templates are pretty useful. For instance, if you wanted to just write a letter, you can select a letter template and all the pieces are here. You just need to fill them in. Now notice when you select a piece, like this area here, it comes up all selected and all you have to do is start typing one character and it replaces it. Same thing with any of the stuff here. These are all placeholders and you can create your own templates with placeholders or you can customize this one. For instance, instead of having this be a generic address here, I'm just going to type in my address and then I'm going to create a new template and then I'm going to save it so then I don't have to type all that every time I create a new letter. So for instance, let's say I've got all that done. I can go and then say save as template under file and I can add to the template chooser. And this will bring up the template chooser but it will select the my templates section. So it won't be under stationery but under my templates and it gives me the chance to name it. So now I can name it my letter. I'm going to close this, delete it, and let's say I want to do this again. I want to go and create my own letter here. Instead of selecting this one, classic letter, and having to re-enter my name and address again, I can go all the way to the bottom to my templates or just select my templates there and select this and you can see that's already filled in. Notice these aren't placeholders anymore. These are just filled in with that. I hadn't changed any of these so they're still the placeholders and I can still continue and fill this out. I just don't have to do this every time. Now it's pretty easy to create your own template from scratch. So I'm going to start here with a blank template and I'm going to put in different things here. I'm just going to keep it really simple just to give you the idea. And then I'm going to just do a little formatting here, move this over to the right, and when I where I want to create a placeholder, I select the text that's going to be the placeholder and I will go to Format Advanced and Define as Placeholder Text. And you can see there's a keyboard shortcut for that as well. That's Control Option Command and T. So now I can do that really quickly with the rest of them. Create that as one, that, that. I'm only going to do this right here. And that. So now I've created all this placeholder stuff and now I can do the same thing I did before and just do a save as template. When you add to the template chooser you not only get to name it but while you're here whether you're just saved one or you're opening a new one you can control click on any of these to rename or delete them so you can kind of keep things neat and organized in here by doing that. And now if I were to select this and choose a template, notice now that it didn't open it up as my letter 2. It opened it up as an untitled document. And in fact, if I go to save it just with Command S here, it's going to ask me for a name. So that ensures that I don't save this template over itself. I don't start to edit it and then accidentally replace the template. And notice here, these are all placeholders, so I can just click them and then start typing. This is not a placeholder. The X is. Right there. Probably be better if I would use something like name so it would be easier to select. You can also insert media placeholders. So if there's some place in your document, for instance, where you wanted to put a something where they replaced a photo, you see I put that in there and I save this as a template, that is actually going to then be there all the time. I can still replace it of course, but if I go to Format Advanced Define as Media Placeholder, then I get this button here at the bottom. So now if I were to click that button, it actually brings up the media browser and I could easily replace it. I could also drag and drop an image right into there. So you can do text placeholders like this and you can do media placeholders like this. You can also insert dates. So I'm going to do date and time. And then the thing about these are that you click on them and then you get to choose a format and you get to set to today or bring up a calendar view. Unfortunately, this doesn't change to be the current day or current time. So it's a little tricky, but it's still great to put up there. Like if you want to put a date here at the top of your letter, just to put it there to make it easier to select or hit the set to today button. Templates are also a great way to have quick access to your formats, your special styles that you create. So for instance, I've created my format 1 and I set it to a special format. I did my format 2. I haven't yet done that. This is how you do it. You click on the style here and I'm going to click plus and I'm going to call this one my format 2. So now I've got these. I can delete them, type some new stuff, select it, and set it to say my format 1. Now if I were to save as a template, even though this is a blank document, let me actually clear this out completely and save it as a template. Call it styles. And now if I were to create a new document using styles, notice that I've got the my format 1 and my format 2 already saved in there. So if you have a whole bunch of different formats you like to use, even if it's a blank template, template's a good way to quickly, instead of selecting blank when creating a new document, you can create your own blank called styles or something and have quick access to those styles.